Hi guys, this is Mal Devino Doroshenko channel. Welcome to our broadcast, and today we're gonna talk about very interesting thing, about 10 things you gotta know before dating a Filipino girl. Well, every person is different, of course, but still there is a thing as some national features. So let's discuss what you gotta know about dating a Filipino girl, talking from my experience. Well, number one, what I would like to underline is you gotta be maximum honest with Filipino girls. Look, like in Europe, it's got common when wife can anytime take phone of husband, and it's got common when husband takes phone of the wife every time. They're like, yeah, because we say that you gotta respect my privacy, I can have some personal talks, blah blah blah. With Filipino girls, guys, you gotta be 100% open, okay? 100% open. Like in our family, I can take phones of my wife anytime I like, and she can take my phone anytime she likes. We know each other's passwords, we know each other's Facebooks. So this is the best glue for good relationship with a Filipino girl, okay? Be maximum open. Maximum open. Let you take your passwords, let you take what you talk about, that's okay. If you talk with your friends, with guys, they're not gonna check, okay? But it's better when every time she can take your phone, your Facebook and see, okay? That's number one I can tell you about this. Number two, Filipino girls really like to cook and they like to eat. Okay, get used to this. Well, again, for me it's very good. And for many guys like me, we really, really love when our wives cook a lot, when we are full, you know, when we are happy. However, in some European countries, some people prefer to go to a restaurant or somewhere. Some modern girls don't really cook all the time. Well, it's okay. But Filipino girls love cooking and love eating. Prepare that sometimes you can get in the kitchen and you're gonna find some very weird smells, very weird cookings, but when you taste it, you're gonna love it. It's always very, very tasty. Extremely, extremely tasty. So, and when you go out, prepare that your wife, your girlfriend, Filipino girlfriend, Filipino wife will be happy to go to some cafeterias, some restaurants to eat. Okay, maybe most of the time Filipino girls are gonna eat rice with something what they like, some usual food, but that must be, okay? Filipino girls don't like to stay hungry, and for me I think it's a wonderful thing. It's not good when a girl is hungry, she's not that happy. Filipino girls like to eat and like to cook, and this is extremely cool feature. I really, really love it, okay? Number three, what I've noticed is that, I don't know why, this is for me, it's a very interesting national feature, but not many Filipino girls love walking on foot for a long time, okay? For example, like for me, if I can walk 1 hour, like 5 kilometers, 6 kilometers, it's a pleasure, it's kind of relaxation. As you can see also in Europe, in different Western countries, people love walking, they don't take cars, they walk. But maybe because Philippines is not a big country, maybe because there are a lot of tricycles in the Philippines and they are not so expensive, and every time you go somewhere you take tricycles, but Filipino girls don't really walk much. Okay, so once you go somewhere, prepare to take transportation, maybe a car, maybe a taxi, maybe anything, but walking for a long time is not gonna work with them. That's very interesting, but you gotta keep it in your mind, okay? Number four, what I would like to say is that Filipino girls are very, very emotional. Okay, it's like Italians, you know, Italian people are very emotional, they always speak loud, they always have a lot of some hand gestures, yeah? And that's pretty cool, you know, that's pretty cool, they're like living people. Filipino girls are very emotional. Okay, they can be absolutely happy, 100% happy to the sky, and also absolutely angry. So life with them is not gonna be boring. It's not very often when you can see some very, very calm and family, you know, Filipino girls, okay? Usually they have burning emotions, they have a burning heart, which is also very cool. I mean, at work, yeah, they have slow, they're speaking nicely, they're speaking softly, but don't be deceived by this, okay? Because when you see Filipino workers, they're very calm, very soft, and you think like, oh, okay, that's the way they're gonna behave in the family. No way. All this calmness is gone, and they're living beings, emotions, they can never hide. The emotions is they don't want to hide their emotions, okay? If she's angry, she's angry. If she's happy, she's happy. So, before you start dating a Filipino girl, be ready that it's gonna be a volcano of emotions. But life with this volcano is gonna be pretty, pretty interesting.
Okay, guys, number five in our list of things you gotta know before dating a Filipino girl. That's, I would like to say, traditions. Okay, traditions in Filipino families, traditions in the Philippines are very different from what we have in other countries. Okay, for some people it may look a bit strange, for some people it's not that strange. Well, anyway, you gotta used to this, because no matter where your Filipino wife or girlfriend lives with you, maybe even outside of the Philippines, traditions of the family, traditions of the country even, are very important for you. So if, for example, if it's some event, like a wedding or a funeral, let's say, then there must be a lot of people. There must be a lot of visitors, okay? Like in Europe, in other countries, in Russia, it's not this way, yeah? If you have some events, if you have some holidays, maybe some people are gonna come, but other people may be busy with work, yeah? But in the Philippines, it's absolutely different. A lot of people are gonna come, a lot of food are gonna be cooked. It will take thousands and thousands of dollars and hours of time, and it's absolutely normal. That's kind of tradition. So, if you are in the Philippines, if you are visiting the country of your girlfriend or wife, the Philippines, get ready that there will be a lot of people around, a lot of relatives, a lot of friends. That if you are having a wedding in the Philippines, there will be hundreds, literally hundreds and hundreds of people who will come. Okay, so that's the tradition, that's the country's tradition that absolutely must be followed. Okay, talking about number six tradition is that Filipino girls, I would like to say, talking about pets and animals. Well, in Europe, in other countries, many ladies, many girls are just crazy about cats, about dogs. Some, they're just super crazy about that, yeah? But in the Philippines, many ladies, they like cats and dogs, but they're not that crazy as it happens in some European and Western countries, okay? So, if you wanna have a cat, that's or a dog, it's okay, that's cool, okay? Your Filipino wife or girlfriend is gonna be absolutely fine with it. But don't expect you to be like over, like, oh, it's our kitty, oh, it's our dog. It's not gonna be like that. Your emotions are gonna be kind and sweet, but not over, not too much about the pets, okay? That's very important to know. Number seven that I would like to say is about some cell phone culture. Well, according to statistics, Philippines is number one country that uses phones longer than other country, okay? On average, a Filipino uses Facebook 9 hours a day. Well, that's why our number seven on our list is cell phone culture. Filipinos love phones. They love Facebook, okay? If you go in the Philippines, you will see a lot of people staying on Facebook 24 hours, literally. Okay, so if your girlfriend or wife, your Filipino girlfriend or wife is too much on Facebook, is too much online, don't worry too much. That's part of their national feature too. A lot of people do it. They stay, they post photos, they post selfies all the time. So if you are a photo lover, if you love taking selfies, if you love taking photos of different people, you will be absolutely happy to know about this feature of Filipino girls. Everywhere they go, they must take selfies. Everywhere they go, they must take a lot of photos and videos. So that's why there are a lot of successful bloggers who are Filipinos, who earn even money from YouTube and things like that. And continuing this idea, in the Philippines, you gotta know that in the Philippines, Facebook totally substitutes Google. Okay? Well, if you look for some information, people go to Facebook. If you need a lawyer, they type it on Facebook. If they need to see the nearest restaurant, they type it on Facebook. Okay? They do not go to Google. Many companies, many people, they don't even have websites. They just have Facebook pages. So people in the Philippines, it's absolutely normal. While you are searching for something, it's normal to use only Facebook. If you cannot find some website of a lawyer or a company, it's okay because they have Facebook page. That's their logic, okay? Facebook is gonna substitute everything, even Google. Every search, everything must be on Facebook. So number eight feature is that You gotta be gentleman with Filipino girls, girlfriends and wives, okay? While nowadays, unfortunately, being gentleman is not that important as it was before. Now, girls in many countries want to be independent, they want to do everything by themselves. But Filipino girls really like when you are a true gentleman, okay? So, if you want to impress her, you prepare to be romantic, prepare to buy flowers for her, to bring you to restaurants, to help you to carry your bag, to open the car door and other doors in restaurants and houses. So they really appreciate it, okay? That's very important because, maybe because Filipino girls are very, also some of them are very girly, okay? They like to wear beautiful, they like to take care of themselves. That's why actually Filipino girls are one of the most beautiful girls in the world, yeah? Because they still care how they look like, they still care about certain makeup, they still care about good clothes, good fashion. So they require it back from their gentlemen, okay? So if you are with them, prepare to be very nice and very romantic. And it actually makes a beautiful couple when there is a beautiful girl and a man with wonderful manners. So always keep it in your mind, that's how you're gonna make them like it, okay? That's how you're gonna make them love you, with your wonderful manners, flowers, and things like that. I don't think that only things like that make them happy, okay? Of course, you gotta be loyal, you gotta be good, you gotta be hardworking. But that's one of the features that you gotta know before dating a Filipino girl, okay? So, talking about Number nine is that Filipinos and mostly Filipino girls, they value education a lot. Okay, you gotta be focused when if you wanna have family, if you wanna have kids, prepare that these kids must have good education and your wife will require it. In the Philippines, you can see a lot of universities. Okay, everywhere you go, you can see a lot of universities. And one of the main reasons when OFWs go abroad is to pay for education of their kids. Maybe some adults now don't have education and the percentage of educated people in the Philippines now is not that high, but Filipinos really value education, okay? That's why it's very, very important for your kids to have good education late. If you're really serious, if you really have wife and you have a kid, prepare that these kids must have good education. This is very, very critically important for your Filipino wife, okay? And the last feature about the Filipino girls that you gotta know is that above this all, everybody is different, okay? Every person is different and every Filipino, they may have these features and probably they will have one or maybe even all of the features we spoke today. But still, everybody is individual, everybody is different. So, yes, they're sweet, they're nice, and when you start dating, prepare to observe, prepare to know your partner more. Do not just follow all the guides you hear or articles you read because every person is absolutely different. Take time to learn your partner. Take time to know what she likes and what she doesn't like. And the most important, be honest about discussing how you look, how you imagine your future relationship, your future family. So when you start making the foundation of this, and you start making the foundation of future good relationship and family, you know everything. Thank you guys. Bye-bye.